as we think about those verses, that you and I are an ambassador for Christ and God the Father. Ambassadors are people who represent nations, and they intercede on behalf of the country they are an ambassador for. So we have a country that is promised to us that we can save. It's a heavenly kingdom. But nevertheless, we are ambassadors right here on earth for the heavenly kingdom that the Father is preparing for those who love him. The next thing, you know, I used to talk to my dad, and he didn't always hear what I was saying, or at least I didn't think he did, and maybe it wasn't worth listening to anyway. But nevertheless, God the Father hears us. He hears our every prayer. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 6, it says, "But when you pray, go into your room or closet, shut the door, and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you." I like it. I'm going to read that again. "But when you pray," because people say, well, why should we pray? Listen to this verse. Matthew chapter 6, verse 6. "But when you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And when you pray, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles or the pagans or the unbelievers do, for they think they will be heard for their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask." Your Father knows what you need before you ask. What a Father we have in our Heavenly Father. As I was following through this theme, this passage of Scripture, we came across the Lord's Prayer. And I wonder if, I know COVID has restrictions, but as I read through this, that we could corporately say the Lord's Prayer. "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debt, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For if you forgive others their trespasses," listen to this, "for if you forgive others their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses." Those last two verses could be quite frightening for any of us that is harboring bitterness against a brother or a sister. But in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 16, the writer of Hebrews says, "Let us therefore come boldly under the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help us in times of need." Now all we got to do is go back up to the Lord's Prayer and focus on what the writer was saying there. Let's just take a look back there. Our Father in heaven, do you call God your Father in heaven? No, hallowed be your name. For glorious is your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. What is God's will here on earth today? It's that men and women, boys and girls come to saving faith in Christ, so that when time as we know it is no more, we have an eternal home in heaven. You know, with the rising cost of food and gasoline and building supplies, we wonder. But if we're in relationship with God and ask Him to supply our needs, and I've been reminded of so many times when we was doing mission work, that it was the need God supplied, not what I might have wanted or somebody else. God was faithful for 17 plus years in providing the needs that we needed for the ministry that we carried out. And we were able to see because we were His ambassadors, preaching evangelistic, teaching pastors and church leaders how to better understand some of the concepts of God's Word. We've seen people come to Christ and faith in Jesus and rise up, and some of those people have come to be pastors and leaders in these local churches in different countries. Because our Heavenly Father is a rewarder to all who follow Him. In Ephesians chapter 6, verses 1 through 4, and I didn't do this, and I know how foolish it was, but I didn't know the Lord, and I didn't know the Lord had a plan. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1 through 4 says, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord." In the Lord. For this is right. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. For this is right. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with promise, that it may go well with you, and that you may live long in the land. And then this, fathers, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up in the discipline and instruction of the Lord. Some very sound advice there. Both for children and parents. Every good and every perfect gift is from above and cometh from the Father of light, with whom there is no variation, neither shadow or turning. James chapter 1, verse 17. So what about us here today? Do you really believe we have a Heavenly Father who knows all things, does all things well, and has mine and your best interest at heart? And if we believe this and apply it to our lives, things will go much smoother. Does that mean that we can ask our Heavenly Father for anything and he will give it to us. I've never experienced that. But the things that I really need, God has provided, both spiritually and physically. And let me make this very clear. It has not always been in the way I wanted it to be. Because God does not have to answer every beck and call from me or even from you. Because he sees the big picture. He sees the past, he sees the present, and he sees the future. And the future he sees, and the prayer that we ask for, if he answered, would not be the best for us when that time came. So today, beautiful day, whether it rains or shines, let us enjoy Father's Day. Maybe we'll be able to get together with children. We have a son that's been in Montreal and the last 2 years. He's been in lockdown 90% of the time. Haven't seen him except on FaceTime. But sometime this year, hopefully, we are going to be able to be reunited together. So today, fathers, I challenge you to be the fathers that God has called us to be. And we will give him praise and honor and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.